In our last class, we studied that characteristics of chemical reaction. There are five characteristics: formation of precipitate, evolution of gas, change in color, change in temperature, and change in state. Okay, based on those characters, we will study the properties or we will categorize the composition of reaction. Then, in this class, the next topic of your chemistry, that is chemical equations. Okay, then the name only suggests chemical equation means the writing of chemical in the equation form. Then why you should write the chemical reactions in the equation form? Just take an example. You have your Aadhaar number. Yes or no? Yes. What it indicates, your Aadhaar number? When you enter your Aadhaar number, it gives the all your details. Instead of writing your name, your area, your date of birth or some other details, just you enter your Aadhaar number, it gives all your details. Like that, in your exam, you only write your exam seat number only, not your name, class or whatever it may be. The only that number indicates you are from this class and this roll number and this name. Because of that, to decrease the lengthiness, in short form only, we will able to study the all property. Because of that, there is one more topic, that is chemical reaction. Just take one example. When the solid magnesium reacts with the sulfuric acid, it forms magnesium sulfate with the liberation of hydrogen gas. Okay, this is one type of explanation. When the magnesium reacts with the sulfuric acid, it forms magnesium sulfate with the liberation of H2 gas. Instead of the writing in these words, I can also possible to write like this. When magnesium is react with the H2SO4, it gives MgSO4 magnesium sulfate with the liberation of H2 gas. Okay, whatever I explain that magnesium reacts with H2SO4, all are present in this equation. Means the first one in the word form is somewhat lengthier. Okay, in this also again we will give some extra information. Magnesium is solid and the sulfuric acid is concentrated or dilute in present in the liquid form, and this one is magnesium sulfate which is present in the aqueous form and which is present in gaseous form in the reaction only. But when you explain the words, it converts. Well, solid magnesium is react with the concentrated sulfuric acid, it forms aqueous magnesium sulfate with the liberation of H2 gas. With the liberation of H2 gas. Okay, this is a somewhat lengthier. Instead of that, I only explain in this equation. To explain the more number of chemical equations in our chemistry, we have more than crore together chemical equations are there. To explain those chemical equations in a simple way, the next term and the next topic, that is chemical equations, the representation of the reactions in a simple way, that is nothing but a chemical equation. And take one more. When sodium hydroxide is reacted with the hydrochloric acid, it forms sodium chloride with the liberation of water. Okay, this is also one equation. But I can also write it in the equation form, that when sodium hydroxide is reacted with the hydrochloric acid, it forms NaCl with the liberation of H2O. Okay, in equation also we will easily find out what are the atoms are present and what are the valencies and how it produces either in the gaseous state or in liquid or either in aqueous state, either it forms precipitate or not. In equation we will study these all in detail. Because of that, we will establish the topic, that is chemical equation. Then the chemical equation can be written in two form. One is a chemical equation in terms of word equation, and another one is chemical equation in terms of symbol and a formula. Okay, both are represents the chemical equation only, but in the first one we will write in the word form, but in the second one we will write it in the divided in two form. One is a chemical equation in terms of chemical equation in terms of word equation, and another one chemical equation in terms of symbols and a formula. Okay, both represent the same, but the representation is in the different way. As I already explained that word means by using words I can write our reaction. But in chemical, in symbol and formula, we will convert that word into formula. Okay, before going to these two, you should know how to write the formula into words. Okay, one of your friend asked me, when magnesium is react with the oxygen, it forms magnesium oxide. Okay, on that day I write 2 here. But your friend asked, sir, why should I write 2 here? Why not like this? MgO2 means Mg is react with the O2, it forms MgO. Why should I write this? But why not this? Here also 2 oxygen to oxygen, 1 Mg and 1 Mg. Here also 2 magnesium and 2 oxygen. Why this one is a correct and why this one is a wrong? See here, when you write like this, the valency goes wrong. Okay, yes, you should balance the chemical reaction, but not in this way. During balancing the chemical reaction, the valency should satisfy. Because of that, in this case, the valency of Mg is 2 and also valency of oxygen is 2. Because of that, you don't write the magnesium oxide like this. If you write like this, then this one is wrong. Okay, then today I will send you the valency chart. Before coming to the next class, you should study that valency chart. Okay, what are the valency 1, valency 2, valency 3, valency 4, what are the negative valencies and what are the positive valencies. I will send you that chart. Okay, before coming to next class, you should thoroughly that chart. Okay, then before going to writing the symbol, yes, how to write? Just take one example, that is calcium. If I write calcium, calcium chloride, is how to convert this word to formula. Okay, means in the conversion from word to symbol or formula, you should know about how to convert that calcium chloride to symbolic form. Okay, calcium means Ca, Ca chloride means Cl. You should write only like this, then this one is wrong. Okay, because of that only you should know about the valency. Just in 9th class you already studied the valencies. Okay, how to find out the valency and how to write the valency, how to calculate the valency and how to write the formula. Okay, once again I will just remind you, then write the calcium and what about chloride is Cl. Always the positive terms written first followed by the negative term. Okay, if you write Cl Ca, then this one is wrong, because Cl is negative radical and Ca is a positive radical. Hence, because of that, in every reaction the positive terms or positive radicals should be written first and followed by the negative radical. Okay, then you should satisfy its valency. Yes, according to the valency, what is the valency of calcium? The calcium is the atomic number 20, then write 2, 8, 2. You know the how to write the electronic configuration. Calcium is a atomic number 30 and this becomes, this is the electronic configuration. According to the chemistry, if to satisfy its means to make it stable, what are the rules? To make it stable, in the outermost shell it should contains minimum 8 electrons. Okay, except the helium, it is in the doublet rule, but after that all should be in the octet rule. Okay, to make it the octet, what are the rules? This is the outermost shell. In outermost shell it should contains 8 electrons. Okay, but in our outermost shell there are only 2 electrons. Okay, when you remove these 2 electrons it becomes 8. Okay, but there is a one more way When you add 6 electrons, then also it becomes the 8. But which one is easier? Okay, just from Gadar to Mundargi, there are two ways. Okay, one is the distance is 20 km, and another one way it covers 80 km. Which one is easier? Either you follow the 20 km or 80 km. Yes, of course, 20 km. Which one is easier? 20 km. Like that, removal of 2 electrons is easier than adding of 6 electrons. In both ways, also it becomes stable. But the adding of 6 electrons is somewhat more difficult than removal of 2 electrons. And I already explains when you have electrons 1, 2, 3 in outermost shell, you should remove electrons. Okay. When you have 7, 8, 7, 6, and 5, you should add the electrons. Okay. If you have 2 electrons, then you should remove electrons. Then it becomes, when you remove electrons, it becomes 2, 8, 8. Now it is a stable and outermost shell, it contains 8 electrons. Yes. Then you are removing 2 electrons. When you remove the 2 electrons, what charge? Removal of electron, it is a cation. Addition of electron, it is a anion. When you remove the electrons, the removal or the release of electron, it gets a positive charge. Okay. Then how many electrons are you removed? 2 electrons. Hence you should write 2 electrons. Then the valence of calcium is 2 plus. Because of that, the valence of calcium is 2 plus. It is the valence of calcium. Like that, if you have one more, that is chlorine. Okay. Cl. The atomic number 17 and the electron configuration 2, 8, 7. 2, 8, 7 is a electronic configuration. Okay. Yes, I have explained, if you have the 7 electrons, which is the outermost shell. This is the outermost shell. In outermost shell, if you have 7 electrons, you should add one more electron. The removal of 7 electrons also make it stable, but addition of 1 electron also make it stable. Which one is easier? The addition of 1 electron is easier. Then you add one more electron, then it becomes Cl 2, 8, 8. Now it is a stable. This is the outermost shell, it becomes stable. The addition of electrons, it gets a negative charge. How many electrons are added? 1 electron. Then it is a Cl minus 1. Right? Cl minus 1. Okay. Ca 2 plus and Cl minus 1. Okay. Now cross its valency. Okay. Right? Cross its valency. Then it becomes its formula. Valence of Ca is 2. Then cross here and 1 is. Don't worry about these charges. Okay, these charges only to indicate whether it is a negative radical or positive radical. During writing the valency, don't worry about these charges. Okay, only write the number Ca 1 and Cl 2. Okay, whenever you have one, no necessity of writing the number. Hence, the formula of calcium chloride is Ca Cl 2. This is a correct way. Because of that, I will send you the valency chart. Okay, don't worry. If you have more than 100 elements and some compound valencies, I will send before coming to next class or during writing the chemical reactions. That chart should be present with you. That makes the writing of chemical reaction is in the easier way. Okay. Then I will give you some homework. Before coming to the class, you should write, and afterwards I will explain the how to convert and how to balance the chemical reactions. Okay, to balance chemical reactions, you should know about the how to write a formula. Okay, if you write the valency in a wrong way, then whole chemical reactions becomes wrong. Okay, then in the class you should write. Before coming to next class, you should write the formula for these all word equations. Now I will solve only one, that combined formula. Then you will find out in your home. Then the magnesium carbonate. Okay, I am sending you the valency chart. Then magnesium is in the valency Mg 2 plus, and the carbonate is in the valency CO3 okay, during the same charge, okay, it becomes electrically neutral. Okay, when you have the same charge, it becomes electrically neutral. In the same charge, you should write only MgCO3. Okay, because both have the same charge and means same charge plus 2 and 2. Because of that, it becomes the same MgCO3. Okay, and when you have the sodium carbonate. The sodium is Na plus 1 and the carbonate is CO3 2 minus 2. Okay. Whenever you are writing the chemical reactions, the positive radical should be first and followed by the negative radical. In this case, sodium is a plus 1 and carbonate is minus 2. Okay. Here, the charges are different, but in here the charges are same, hence it becomes electrically neutral. But here charges are not same. Okay, hence the cross over valency. Okay, Na 2CO3. This is a formula. Okay, before coming to the next class, you should solve these all. And the one more, whenever you are writing your reactions, there are some atoms: hydrogen, oxygen, chlorine, bromine, iodine, fluorine, nitrogen, all noble gases. You should write these in a doublet rule, doublet formula. Means you don't write only H in your chemical equations. Okay, you should write the H2, O2, N2, Cl2, like this, because these all are present in the diatomic form, not in the monatomic form. Because of that, whenever you are writing the chemical reactions or chemical equations, if you have the hydrogen, you should write a H2. If you have oxygen, then you should write a O2, N2 and Cl2, because these all are diatomic in nature, not a monatomic. Okay, then this is about today's class. In next class, I will explain how to balance the chemical reactions and how to write the chemical reactions. Thank you.